CS8661 Internet Programming Laboratory, Exercise Number 6, Convert the Static Web Pages of Programs into Dynamic Web Pages using Servlets. Okay, you all know about the servlets. Here there is a, see this picture, that is a static website. That HTML program is connected to the JS and CSS. But in the dynamic website, there is a HTML program is connected to JS, PHP, that is a storage, that is MySQL, database, and CSS. Okay, let's see the explanation and programs. Aim of this program, to convert the static pages into dynamic pages. Procedure, first we want to create a HTML program form. That is entering the password, username, and card number. Then the HTML program will be, there is a, if there is a password is invalid, means invalid user will be displayed. Then there is a servlet program. That is you want to compile the servlet program and you want to place it, that class file, in that Tomcat, web apps, XML, that is a web INF, include that classes. Inside the class file, you want to copy the class file and paste it. Then only the servlet will be executed. Okay, then you want to compile the program. Then we can open the web browser. Right, this is a program. First server.java. Here, the HTTP servlet request response, that is very important, that is included. And the string parameters, all these and all included, that username, password, that card number. Then next program, that is a success.java. Okay, here for a checking, that is a correct login or not, a shopping cart is correct or not, like that. For that purpose, we have created this Java program. And this is a HTML form. Here only we will enter the username, password, and card ID. Then this is the output. Let's see the execution of this program. So inside the E colon, I have placed two Java program, that is named as a SER and success. Let's execute this program. Already I have opened that command prompt. You all know that. First you want to set the Java path and then set the class path. Okay, I will execute that. That is a Java C hyphen class path. That is you want to copy that Tomcat server. For that we can open that path. My computer C colon program files. Apache Software Foundation, Tomcat 7.0 and lib. You can copy that path and open that command prompt and paste it. Paste it that and slash servlet hyphen API dot jar. Close the double quotes and the file name is first one ser.java. So enter. Here the class file is created. That is a no error. Okay. Then you want to create one more class path for next servlet program. So Java C hyphen class path double quotes. Then paste it slash servlet hyphen API dot jar. Then a program name is success.java, enter. So this is also executed and class file is created. So let's check it in the E colon. So here see that ser.class, success.class. So copy these both files and you want to place it in the server, Tomcat server. So C colon program files, Apache Software Foundation, Tomcat 7.0 and web apps, examples, web INF, classes. So here you want to paste it. So already there is, that both the files are there. So I am copying and replacing because previously I have executed that. Then next, after completing this, click web apps, web.xml. You want to include the path. Here this is default. Already I have included this one. Let's see that here there is a ser name. Okay. That is a servlet name class. And username, there is a parameter here that we are going to use. That is a username, password and card ID. The next program, that is a success. Okay. These and all very much important. Because if you didn't include this, you can't execute the web application. Okay. Now, let's execute that program. I have placed that HTML program in that web apps, examples, servlets. That is in.html. Click that. The program is executing. So username, user 1, then password pwd1, then card ID 111. Then click the login. So after clicking the login, that is a login is success. This is your shopping cart number. The number is correct means this message will be displayed. So we have successfully executed the program.